swear to you, my words are true. I started running towards him. But then I was blinded by a flash. It was so bright that I hardly saw anything for a good dozen seconds. But I kept running forward. As I arrived in Whitechapel, I heard a woman screaming. And then I was caught by the police. But there wasn't a trace of that man. Of course, then they found a gun and all that blood. I couldn't see the murderer escaping and all that mess. Perhaps I was still half-blinded at that moment.
A thrilling account, my young man. Layton, are you able to describe the person whom you saw standing in Half Moon Street?
Well, I wasn't able to see his face at all. It was too dark, and he was too far away. I could see his silhouette.
And what about that?
Nothing so special. He was wearing a jacket. He was quite average in size and his weight.
I see. Was there anything else that struck you at the time?
No. But perhaps it's strange, but I can't remember the sound of his footsteps as he was running away. Perhaps it was because of the fireworks or the surprise of me seeing him.
Layton, I confess I am puzzled. Why should a young lad like you take a gun from the hands of a dead man and set off in pursuit of a probable killer?
I know. I keep wondering that, but at the time it was like a reflex. A criminal ought to be arrested, and he was armed.
You were willing to risk your life. That was a little foolish, unless you wanted revenge.
No, Mr. Holmes. I was just being brave and stupid.
I'm sure that you were, but I believe that you may have recognized one of the victims, Brian Vercotti. You knew that gentleman well, did you not?
How ever could you know that?
You have a typical tattoo of the Westgate Brotherhood upon your hand. I observed exactly the same mark upon Mr. Vercotti. You came to know him from your sharing a past prison sentence. Am I correct, Mr. Chapman?
Oh, God. You're right, Mr. Holmes.
Would you tell me a little about Brian Vercotti?
We were convicted for a robbery. Once in prison, both of us joined one of these fraternities. During that year, we tried to help each other out, you know?
Now, you were quite young then, I believe.
Yes, Mr. Holmes, we were. We'd only stolen a pound of meat. After we were released and when I saw what my little brother had become, I decided to work towards living an honest life.
And Vercotti?
He had a hard time. His sister had died in a Whitechapel dispensary while he was in prison. He had no family anymore. Our paths split. He fell back into crime.
So you lost him?
Yes. And for around 2 years, I heard no news of him at all.
We shall see you soon, young man. Here it is. I need to continue my research in my archives. Here it is. One of the victims, Kenneth Butler, was involved in the story of the stolen Hellenistic treasures. A visit to his pawn shop should tell me more. Mr. Butler's key matches the lock perfectly. Crampons and a sharp ice axe would only be brought here by a mountaineer. a flare pistol. Perhaps it was pawned by a destitute sailor. It looks as though Mr. Butler kept a careful record of his operations. The Ram's Heads. This necklace belongs to the Five Rams of Mitylan collection. Interesting. That means that Kenneth Butler owned a part of this collection all this time, 10 years after the theft. Crampons and a sharp ice axe.
What's up with you, lad? What are you waiting for?
I'm waiting for my brother to be released.
Your brother?
The one that you caught, beat up and imprisoned.
Ah, the murderer.
He ain't killed no one, copper.
Watch your mouth, lad, else you'll be joining that worthless brother of yours.